now someone who serves in the capacity of leadership on behalf of the New Jersey Conference of Mayors, Mayor Jim Perry, to share with us his own story. Jim.
Thank you, Governor Reedy, Governor Christie, for having me out to this. Thank you all for coming out. I want to introduce myself. My name is Jim Perry. I'm the mayor of Hardwick Township in Warren County. I'm president of the State Conference of Mayors and vice president at the municipalities. And I have a drug problem. I'm going to give you a short version of my problem. Otherwise, I have to be here all night. 2015, October 15th, 2015, I was on the phone with my son, who was in Pennsylvania, he was out in Florida, and we wanted to make it together on the telephone. The next day, we tried to call him all day long, getting no answer. Come 6 o'clock, I figured he'd be out of work, maybe he couldn't talk because he was at work. I finally reached out to the apartment complex he was at. They said, as far as there was lights were. So I called the police. At this point, I had already known what my outcome was going to tell me. The police called me back about a half hour later and told me, Mr. Perry, I'm sorry to inform you that we have found your son deceased on the living room floor of his apartment. The first thing that came to mind me to ask was, did you find any drugs? I had suspected, wasn't totally sure if he was doing drugs, but my daughter and I both suspected. And sure enough, they said yes, they did find drugs in the apartment. It ended up, he had died of fentanyl overdose and mixed with alcohol. And the hardest part came next when I had to get in the car and drive from where I live in Warren County to Morris County, down to Morristown to let my daughter know that her brother had passed away. The minute she saw me get out of the car, she fell to her knees in the driveway, which she had also suspected. Fell to her knees crying, saying, my brother's dead, isn't he? You're here to tell me Chesson's dead. And that was a very hard thing to go through, and that's not where it ends. 1 year later, 1 year, 1 week later, I get a call from my sister that my niece Amber was found in the bedroom that morning dead of a heroin overdose. So within 1 year, we lost two family members. And why I say I have a drug problem is because it is a drug problem. What my family's gone through, what my son went through, what my niece went through, it affects us all. And it's a major epidemic. It's worse than I even imagined. So that is the purpose. The other purpose of what I want to get out to people is the stigma of what a drug addict or somebody that has a problem with drugs is. It's not like when I was younger. It could be anybody. And obviously, what we're here for tonight, there's people that have gone through it. Other places where I give talks where there's a lot of executives, there's a lot of doctors, lawyers, and I always guarantee them that within the audience that we have, 200 to 300 people, there's always at least 20 to 30 people in that audience that have a drug problem themselves, whether it's the addict themselves, or whether it's a family member that's going through what I had to do. And let me tell you, the grief afterwards and the relief that I didn't have to worry about my son anymore was even harder, because now I felt the guilt that I didn't, I felt relief. So the other thing I want to mention is that I made my, as president of the Conference of Mayors, to make it my mission to push awareness and support for this cause. And with Governor Christie has put out a pledge for all mayors to sign, which I have my signed copy here, and we have numerous mayors across the state who have signed a copy of the pledge to support the fight against the opioid crisis. And I urge all mayors throughout the state to please sign this, get it back, and do everything you can, work with us to fight this epidemic. So with that, I don't want to speak too long because there's a number of speakers and it's cold out. I appreciate that everybody's out here in support of families like mine,